Hello everyone, my name is Maxim Arkhangelsky and today we continue our how-to videos section with the case how to configure replication job and Veeam backup and replication to Veeam Cloud Connect. So Veeam Cloud Connect replication, a really high level overview, so just two slides for you to investigate on that. So Veeam backup and replication provides disaster recovery capabilities, and one of them is synchronization of your virtual machines into service provider data center, so you can arrange a disaster recovery process with the following scenarios and options. So Veeam backup and replication to Veeam backup and replication, and Veeam backup and replication to Veeam Cloud Connect. So scenarios which are supported is vSphere to vSphere, vSphere to vCloud Director is supported from Veeam Backup and Replication to Veeam Cloud Connect only. From vCloud Director to vCloud Director, this replication is supported between Veeam Backup and Replication scenarios, and Hyper-V to Hyper-V is supported for both Veeam Backup and Replication and Cloud Connect scenarios. Probably you've already noticed from previous lessons that you might have several customers assigned to a service provider, and Veeam Cloud Connect is an effective product working with the tenancy and split the environments between each other, so each customer will not be able to see another one until you configure a different configuration. So Cloud Connect replication is the case where you do not need to configure a lot of network and security stuff. It's all done within the wide area network, within the cloud gateway, which is the component built in Veeam Cloud Connect product, and data is transferred via secure SSL tunnel. So architecturally, how it looks like in the customer environment: you usually have VMware environment, you have Hyper-V environment, and you create a replication job in Veeam Backup and Replication. So for most of customers, for most of tenants, they should have Veeam Backup and Replication. They just create a job, so it has scheduling options, it has different pre-IP configurations if needed, and they have an option to run a failover of the virtual machine set which they have in the current infrastructure. So cloud gateways act as a load balancers, so it might be only one or many, or one to many is also possible. So different scenarios and approaches could be done. It just depends on your infrastructure and needs. In the service provider environment, what should be here? So there are kind of a lot of components here, but they are optional. So first of all, you should have a Cloud Connect and Cloud Gateways. You should have disaster recovery hosts where you will place replicas from your customers. And in case of vCloud Director, you have a different way of doing things. So you have organizations and you just assign organization resources for Veeam Cloud Connect tenant. So replicas landing to your service providers will just reside under the organization created in vCloud Director. There is one more component shown here, so it's Veeam Service Provider Console, which might be a tool or a managed solution where your customers might run failover plans. So once replica has been configured and allocated to Cloud Connect, if you have this tenant already specified, for example, if by any reason your customer lost his entire infrastructure, he may log into Web UI of Veeam Service Provider Console and run a failover plan here. And now let's go into my lab and I will show you how to configure this specific type of job. So here is my lab, and when you make a regular replication job within your environment, you go to the inventory tab and for sure you add the server as the source and destination. If we speak about the service provider environment, for tenants, Veeam Backup and Replication server, we have backup infrastructure tab and this service provider line here. It's just as you create a backup repository, as you create backup proxies. So here you have a specific line for service provider connectivity. So you should add basically a service provider. So there is nothing about backup resources you would like to request. There is nothing about the CPU, RAM, networking, about vCloud Director, so you just establish a connection. And you can also allow this Vim backup and replication installation to be managed by the service provider, just in case you would like to have some assistance. So let me show you my existing connectivity. So here you put DNS name or IP address with the single port, which is an external port of Cloud Gateway, which is already deployed in service provider environment. I don't have this checkbox. I don't want anyone to see my backups and replicas and manage my infrastructure. On the next step, we have here credentials, which should be provided by the service provider, and certificate, which is also mandatory to establish this connectivity. So this certificate is provided by service provider as well. Then you apply, and actually that's it. So this secured connection will be established with the service provider, and you will have more resources in your environment. So you will have extra repository and extra replication resources if needed. So you just specify if it should be a vSphere job or Hyper-V. Hyper-V is also an option. So you create a replication job, define if you need a replica seeding. So you have an option to create a seed for your replicated virtual machine from the backup. So backup and copy and backup copy job could be a source for replica destination. You can also play around with network remapping and replica VIP. So I will enable all options and we will go through them one by one. On the next step, we should define virtual machines from your environment, from my environment, to be replicated. And let's take a look at demo virtual machine. So I will just make a bulk selection of these ones. Yeah, they are kind of small, but still. And here we go. So here is the destination and host and cluster which we should select. In case of a non-Cloud Connect scenario, you just basically pick the VMware vSphere host from your environment. In case of Cloud Connect, so since I'm already connected, I'm a tenant in Cloud Connect. I have these resources available. They are kind of inherited from service provider environment. So I just click OK. And different IP scheme has been disabled. That's fine. And I have a VApp here. So I can see that it's just the VApp. So nothing to add here. Everything is already done for you by the service provider. And that's it. Just as simple as that. Network remapping, network mapping. So if source and target network are not the same within your environment, so you can create this rule to specify source and target network on within your replication job. So you can pick any and map it to any within the service provider environment for sure. So let's move on. Job settings. So repository for replica metadata. So it's not the repository where your replica will reside in full. So we will keep the data on the host itself. So it will be a data store with this replicated virtual machine. And metadata is just the metadata. So it's not the full virtual machine amount. You can have it renamed. Just maybe for your consideration, you can put here a suffix to identify that this is a replicated virtual machine. And you have a number of restore points to keep it. Literally means that you can roll back your replicas. And we keep snapshots and delta files for each restore point. So it cannot be 99. It's limited to the snapshot amounts of vSphere and Hyper-V. So it's around 30 and less. On the next step, we have here a source and target proxy selection. So source proxy is the one which will process the data from your production host. Target is the one which will receive the data at the destination. You can send data directly or you can send data through built-in WAN accelerator. So it doesn't mean that we will speed up your network by using some CDNs or other magic. This is just the digest comparison before sending the data. So it requires more resources on your in your production environment, and it requires also WAN accelerator in destination part. So here we speak about the service provider environment. It's not always faster, but it really reduces traffic
in several times. So this could be tested. Seeding. So if you would like to seed your replica from backup, you can put this checkbox, define the repository. So cloud repository is my Cloud Connect repository. So it's additional service backup as a service, which is provided by Veeam certified service provider. But yeah, you can use your own if your data resides in the target location, in destination. Mapping. So if by any chance you have some replicas already done previously to service provider environment, or you have well, very like configuration done previously before Cloud Connect establishment, you can map these replicas to existing VMs, and replication chain will go on. So you don't need to transfer a virtual machine in full twice. So you will map these replicas to existing virtual machines. Next option is guest processing. So you can enable application aware processing, but you should put here guest OS credentials. So this option gives you a possibility to recover items from these replicas, from this virtual machine. So you don't need to boot it up, you don't need to run a failover plan to recover some partial data. But for example, for SQL and for Oracle, you can run Veeam Explorers and get data back, like specifically for database on the point in time basis. So it's nice feature to consider when you play around with it. For file level recoveries, it's not necessary. Then schedule. So schedule is a very interesting part, because we speak about the near continuously data protection here. For Cloud Connect scenario, it's not yet supported when we speak about the CDP. So achievable RPO, recovery point objective, is in minutes. So you can run it daily. In most cases, this is much more than enough, because it's a disaster recovery location and you will not synchronize the data within minutes, most likely, because it's a wide area network and etc. But you can run this job, this replication job, periodically on hours basis or even on minutes basis. And if we speak about near CDP, it will be continuously. So it's not CDP, because we don't use VIO API here. We don't synchronize data in two locations immediately. So it still compares changes and send increments to destination host. Yeah. So if your RPO is really minutes, then it's much more than enough to skip continuous data protection. If you don't want to run this replication job, for example, during the peak hours, you can just select this window and mark it as denied. So it means that nothing will be processed during these hours. So it might be stressful sometimes when you want to make a replication job during the peak hours. So if you don't want to stress out your infrastructure, you can just simply deny this replication job. And that's it. So when you have created it, you will have a summary, you apply the settings, and actually the initial configuration is done. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it will save you some time. And see you in the next sections of this series. Stay tuned. Bye.